Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back. My name is GamerLCD, and today I want to talk to you guys a little bit about Killer Instinct. If you guys have been following my channel, and if you're watching this video, I'm pretty sure you are following my channel, you'll probably notice that I've been putting out a lot of Killer Instinct videos lately, and if you don't like fighting games, or if you don't like Killer Instinct in general, then I do apologize for that, but you guys probably don't know this, but I'm a huge Killer Instinct fan, and I remember playing that game way back in the day, back when I was a little kid in the arcades. And I've been waiting so long for them to come out with a reboot of the series or Killer Instinct 3, and they finally done it. So I'm going to put out as much coverage as I possibly can and absorb this game as much as I possibly can. So for those of you guys who are following my channel for Killer Instinct, you guys won't be disappointed. I'm actually planning to live stream Killer Instinct like the second I get my Xbox One, because I will be getting it at midnight, and I'm gonna be rushing right home, plugging it in, hooking up to the Twitch TV, and live streaming Killer Instinct pretty much all night, basically. So you guys can look forward to that. As the date gets closer, I'll be posting more details about when I'm gonna do it, how long I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna be giving away some prizes and things like that. But enough about that. The main topic for this video is going to be discussing the next three character reveals for Killer Instinct. If you guys aren't aware, Killer Instinct is going to be launching in November at launch date with six characters. So, and then two more later on, a couple of months after that. I believe February is when the date that they're pushing for. Well, at least that's the rumor anyway. So six characters at launch, and then two more for season one, for a total of eight. And then season two is going to bring you eight more characters. I believe season two is planned for 8 months to a year after the launch of season one. So it's not too long off. And I mean, they're going to be adding a lot more content later on as via free DLC. So we have a lot to look forward to. So we already know who these five of six characters are going to be. We have Jago, Saberwolf, Glacius, we have Thunder, and we also have the fifth character that was just announced a couple of days ago, which is a new character that they're introducing. It's going to be a spider-like, air combo-ish type character. I did post a teaser trailer for that character on my channel, so if you missed it, go ahead and check that out. I'll put a link to it in the description for the video below, as well as a video link, so you just go ahead and click on that if you have annotations enabled. So, now that we've covered that, I'm going to talk a little bit about character reveals here in a little bit, but I want to get this out of the way first. Let's talk about all the new stuff that you guys might not know about that's in the Gamescom build, as well as future stuff that they're planning to put in the game at launch. So, if you guys can tell from the beginning of this video and the intro, then you'll know that this game is absolutely looking amazing. It's getting better and better with every single build that they put out to the public. And PAX Seattle is actually coming up this weekend. So I actually live in Tacoma, which is only about a 20-minute drive from Seattle. So I'm hoping I'll be able to get down there, or up there anyways, and play some Killer Instinct. If I'm able to, I'll put a lot more coverage and video stuff on my channel. But if I can't, it's going to be a real huge bummer. But I have a friend down there who's going to be able to get me a ticket, I hope. Anyways, guys, let's go ahead and get into today's video topic. All the new stuff in the Gamescom build. Right away, you guys know that Chief Thunder is now playable, and he has his new stage, which is a really reminiscent of his original stage in Killer Instinct 1, which is that huge long bridge over the canyon. And they really stuck with that in Killer Instinct, this new Killer Instinct 3 or Killer Instinct reboot, whatever you want to call it these days. It's still a bridge, and it's still over a canyon, but it's kind of a rocky bridge. It's no longer that wooden bridge from KO1, which is pretty cool that they really kept to his roots. He actually looks the same from Killer Instinct 1 all the way up to this new Killer Instinct. The mohawk is gone. That's kind of a huge bummer, but he still looks pretty much the same. He's a little bit buffer, I would say, but pretty much they really kept to his original character style. One of the cool things you guys probably didn't know about is that we're going to have our choice of announcers in this new KI3. We have the choice of the new announcer, and we also have the choice of the original announcer from Rare, who did the voices for KI1 and KI2. So, personally for me, the original announcer from those games is absolutely amazing. He's actually in the Gamescom build, but in the launch of the game, you're going to have to unlock him. He's not going to be available at the start. You have to figure out how to unlock him. Double Helix said that they're not going to tell us how to unlock him. We just have to figure it out. So, obviously, you know, once someone figures it out, it's going to be posted everywhere on the online. But for those guys who don't like spoilers and like figuring things out for themselves, you're probably going to have a really fun time unlocking the new announcer because the old announcer, because he really is hype. He adds so much value to the game. It's kind of crazy. One of the new cool things also in the Gamescom build that's going to be in the launch of the game is the fact that you have you're going to have the way you do your ultra is going to change what the announcer says. So if you do a single ultra, he's going to stream ultra combo. But if you do a double ultra, then he's going to stream, you know, the original ultra that we heard in the very first version of the E3 build, which is ultra and that really scratchy, awesome voice. So for those of you guys who don't know what a double ultra is, it means you do your initial ultra and then you cancel it. Because everyone gets a cancel, so you cancel it into your additional combos or whatever you want to do, and then you do the ultra again. That is what's called a double ultra, and if you don't drop it, then he does ultra, which is really cool. Which is what you guys heard at the beginning of this video. So if you do a standard ultra, which is you just, you know, initiating the ultra, he does ultra combo, which in my opinion sounds better than just screaming ultra. So I probably won't be doing double ultras anyway. But enough about that. So that's really all the cool new stuff that they added in this build. Some stuff that's going to be available at launch I want to talk about real quick. Original costumes. So if you buy the Ultra Edition of Killer Instinct, you will have access to the original costumes from KI1 and KI2, which is something I'm really looking forward to. I'm not 100% positive on that. I'm not sure you'll have to unlock them or not, but it's one of the key features listed on the Ultra package is that you'll have the original costumes or retro costumes or whatever you want to call them. You'll be able to access the original Killer Instinct game if you buy the Ultra Edition, which is pretty nice. It's not going to have online support, but it is something they're going to work towards later on in a later update for it. It's going to be completely emulated. It's not going to be like an official Xbox One game or anything like that. So it's going to be emulated off the Killer Instinct 3 game. So once you log into the Killer Instinct 3 game or start playing it, then it's going to probably be a menu option to play the original Killer Instinct, which is cool. But they won't have online play off the start for the original KI. So let's actually start talking about the character reveals for Killer Instinct 3. We have three more, and only one of those is going to be on the main roster for the initial launch of the game. So a lot of people have been speculating Orchid and Fulgore. They said there's no way that they're going to launch this game without Fulgore or Orchid. There's just no way. And personally, I would have to agree with them, but I don't think it's going to happen. Simply because they have already announced this new character, which is also a female. So I don't think there's any way they're going to, you know, double announce another female character. I just don't think they're going to do it. I'm pretty sure, because, you know, Fulgore and Orchid are really two of the biggest, they are the biggest names in Killer Instinct. They're the most two popular characters in the franchise, Fulgore and Orchid. And I really think they want to get those characters right. And I think rushing them for an announce this early for launch, I don't think they want to do that. I think they want to give us a really good character styles for Fulgore and Orchid. So I seriously doubt they're going to give us Orchid. Fulgore, I'm not so sure about. They might and might not do it. So Orchid, 100%. They're not going to announce her for the sixth character at launch. There's 100% no way they're going to do it. But Fulgore, maybe. Fulgore, I could see them announcing as the sixth character for launch. But I'm still skeptical at that. So let's go ahead and talk about the sixth character, who we think it's going to be. It's got to be one of the lesser known characters. They've already announced a brand new character. So I don't think they're going to announce another new character for the sixth character for launch. It's just not going to happen. So who do we have left? We have TJ Combo, we have Maya, we have Tusk, we have Kim Woo, we have Riptor, we have Spinal, we have Cinder. So who do you guys think it's going to be? Personally, I think it's going to be one of the lesser known characters that people don't really you know, care about that much. Personally for me, I think it's going to be either TJ Combo or Riptor. And I'll tell you why. Riptor and TJ Combo were never really fan favorites. Riptor, kind of, but not really. So they want to give us a character that, you know, not a whole lot of people are excited about. They just want to get that lesser known character out of the way so they don't have to worry about them later. You know, big characters like Orchid, Fulgore, and Cinder, they're all going to come later. I 100% guarantee it's not going to be the initial launch. So for me, I'm betting that the sixth character is going to be Riptor or TJ Combo, and I'm leaning more towards TJ Combo. So let's talk about the last two final characters. Remember, these two characters are not going to be in at launch. Only six are going to be on the launch date. These last two are going to come in February as the final two characters for Season 1. So, who do we think these are going to be? Again, we go back to Orchid and Fulgore. There's just no way they're going to, you know, let this game go a whole year before they announce those characters for Season 2. There's just no way they're going to do it. So they have to pick one of them, and only one of them is going to be able to get in there. So, who's it going to be, Fulgore or Orchid? Assuming that they didn't already announce Fulgore for season or for this as the sixth launch character. And remember, guys, like I said, PAX Seattle is actually coming up this weekend, and I'm recording this on August 28th. So, this video could be out of date. So, they could have already announced Fulgore by the time you guys are watching this video. But, anyways. Who's it going to be for the seventh character, Orchid or Fulgore? Now, I'm guessing that it's got to be Orchid. I don't think Orchid's going to be in the first six, but she's definitely has to be in the first eight anyways. So the final two have to be Orchid and Fulgore. There's just no way. There's no way that they're going to leave out the two most popular characters in the KI franchise. There's just no way they're going to do it. So I'm guaranteeing that the sixth character they're going to reveal at PAX or whatever they decide to reveal it at, it's going to be TJ Combo. And then for the final two, they're probably not going to announce them at the same time, but it's probably going to be Orchid and Fulgore. It has to be. There's literally no way they couldn't. I could see them possibly replacing one Orchid or Fulgore with Cinder because he's the third most favorite one, the person that they took out of KI2. So there you guys have it. Those are my predictions. TJ Combo for the sixth character to announce at PAX or whatever they decide to do it. And then the seventh and eighth character, it's going to be Fulgore and Orchid or Cinder, whichever one comes first. You guys get the idea. So I want to know what you guys think, though. Who do you guys think the announcement's going to be? And remember, take into account everything that I've discussed throughout this video. You know, the fact that they've already announced a female character and she's already a new character, so they're not going to announce another female character and another new character. It's just not going to happen. So we have to take that into account. So it has to be a male character, number one. Number two, it can't be a new character. So I'm thinking Fulgore for the the final two, and then TJ Combo for the final six. Let me know what you guys think. My name's Gamer LCD. If you have any questions about the different KI packages, they're going to be announced, they're going to be released on the launch date. If you have any questions about ultra combos or how the gameplay works or stuff like that, just go ahead and let me know. I'll be answering those questions for you guys. My name's Gamer LCD. I'm out of here. Thank you guys so much for watching. We are controlling transmission. Ready.